हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑफ दिस लेक्चर सीरीज सिंपली स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड दिस लेक्चर इज बेस्ड ऑन लाइव लोड। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ लाइव लोड ऑन द इंडस्ट्रियल शेड एंड फॉर दिस वी नीड सर्टन पैरामीटर्स दैट विल डिस्कस एंड हाउ टू यूज दोज पैरामीटर्स इन द डिज़ाइन ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल शेड। So as we have discussed in the earlier part also, you need to have a copy of the IS 875 part 2 in this case, as we are discussing about the live load, and so you need a pen, notebook and a calculator as usual, without which you cannot do anything. Then in the later part, as we have discussed, we are going to design this with the limit state method. So we'll be following the similar procedures given by the limit state method. So the first part, the simple thought of the day, which is given by the great scientist again. The good thing about the science is that it is true whether or not you believe in it. That means the science will be always true whether you believe or you don't believe, doesn't matter. So this is given by Neil deGrasse Tyson. And with this particular thought, we'll try to understand what is true and what is not true. So as we have discussed in the earlier part, we are going to design the industrial shed, which is just located in the Kolhapur region, and the specifications of those that particular shed is already given. So we'll not waste our time in that. If you want, you can go back to the earlier video and you can get details of that. So in the earlier video, we have already discussed how to calculate the dead load on the dead load of the industrial shed, considering this is the configuration which has a 42 meter length and 12 meter span and having a height of 10 meter. So considering this, we'll be calculating the live load in this particular lecture. So already we have discussed the dead load part, which we have already discussed in the previous lecture. So today we'll be covering in the live load part, and the later on we'll be trying to cover the wind load part. So for this particular part of live load, we need IS 875 part 2. So get a copy of that so that it will be easier for you to understand the live load concept. So to calculate the live load, as we have already discussed, we are going to use the IS 875 part 2. And using that particular part, we'll be trying to understand the live load concept. So to understand the live load concept on a industrial shed, first you should have a copy of that, and we'll try to understand what are the clauses given in that particular IS code regarding the live load. So I'll go back to the IS code, IS 875 part 2, and you have to refer the clause number or the table number 2 on which it is given. That you can see here, the table number 2 refers to the imposed loads on various types of roofs. That means you're going to understand the imposed loads. Imposed loads is nothing but the live load that you are imposing on the structure. So imposed loads is nothing but the live load that you are considering. So here you can see this is the type of roof and the uniformly distributed area that needs to be applied on that particular roof, or you can apply the point load on that particular area, which will be equivalent to the uniformly distributed load. So again, in this case, you have three types of this. The first one is the flat sloping or a curved roof with the slopes up to including 10 degrees. So that means the roof slope, if it is up to 10 degrees, what clauses you have to follow, and when it is more than 10 degree, what loading that you have to consider. So there are two types: when the angle is less than 10 degree and the angle is more than 10 degree. What does that angle mean is, see, you have a roof that we have already seen in the previous slide, and the roof angle that we are discussing here is this particular angle, which can be calculated by considering the half span, which will be 6 meter in this case, and the rise, that we are considering, which is 2 meter in this case. So for our truss, the span is 12 meter. So this entire length is 12 meter and half of that will be 6 meter and this will be 2 meter. So using these two geometrical parameters, we can calculate the value of roof angle, that is alpha. Now using this particular roof angle, we'll be deciding which clause we have to use. So for that, if the roof angle alpha is more than 10 degree, we'll be using this. And if it is less than 10 degree, we'll be using this particular part. So again, in this case, you have two different clauses. So in the first case, if the access is provided, and in the second case, the access is not provided. So in the access provided case, what does that mean? That means you are allowed to use the roof on a regular basis, where the live load will be more because you are going to use that particular roof on a regular basis. And when the access is not provided, that means you are going to use that particular roof only for the maintenance and not on a regular basis. So the structures like Eiffel Tower can be considered in the access provided stage or access provided structures, where people access the different parts of the structures or the roofs of the structures where the load will be more. And in case of industrial shed that we are discussing, where the roof of the structure is not accessed regularly, where we go on the roof only for the maintenance purpose. So for that case, you are going to refer the second one. But again, it depends whether your angle alpha is more than 10 degree or it is less than 10 degree. So first we'll try to calculate the angle and then we'll try to calculate the live load based upon the roof angle. So in this particular case, we'll first try to calculate the roof angle. So here, your roof angle is the alpha that we have to calculate. And if it is more than 10 degree, we are going to use this particular equation. I'll tell you how you get this equation. And if it is less than 10 degree, you have access provided and access not provided, as we have discussed. So now in this particular case, we'll try to calculate the roof angle. So you can see that the half span is 6 meter and the rise is 2 meter. So considering this, using the trigonometrical ratios, we can find out the value of alpha as tan inverse of 2 by 6, which is 18.43, which is more than 10 degree. So that means the angle of roof that we are using is more than 10 degree. So that means we have to make use of the clause accordingly. So for this particular part, you have slopes of the roof or the sloping roof with a slope greater than 10 degree. So now we are going to make use of this. And what this clause says is, for a roof membrane sheet or a purlins, 0.75 kilonewton per meter square less 0.02 kilonewton per meter square for every degree increase in the slope over 10 degrees. So what does that mean is, up to 10 degree, whatever load that we are considering is 0.75. So up to 10 degree, there is no decrement in the load. We are going to consider only this particular part. But if it is more than 10 degree, we have to reduce this particular load by a certain amount, and that amount is 0.02 kilonewton per meter square for every increase in the degree. So we can put this into an equation so that it will be easier for to understand. So what we have done is, we'll try to apply that into an equation. So since this particular value of alpha is more than 10 degree, this 10 or this alpha minus 10 degree will be a positive value. If it is less than 10 degree, or suppose if the angle of alpha is 9 degree, then this value will be negative, and we are not considering the negative value here because the maximum load that we can apply is 0.75. So what we can do is, we'll consider 0.75 as the total load or the maximum load that we can apply, minus for each degree increment, the load that we have to, for each degree increment, we have to reduce the load by 0.02, will be 0.75 minus alpha is 18.43. Now in this particular case, minus 10, because 18.43 minus 10 will be 8.43. That means 8.43 degree is above the 10 degree, and we have to multiply that with the intensity of 0.02, and that will be the final wind live load that will be applied on the structure. So we'll be calculating that. So we have wind live load 0.75 minus 0.02 minus 0.02, in bracket you have the difference of angle between the actual angle and the 10 degree, which is 18.43 minus 10. So the live load that we are going to get is 0.58 kilonewton per meter square. Now you are going to apply this load on a particular area, and based on that you are going to calculate the total live load. So to calculate the total live load, the area that we are going to apply is the plan area. The reason behind that is the live load will be always acting in the downward direction. It is not going to act in the inclined direction. So because of which, the load will be acted upon the horizontal area, that is the plan area, not the inclined roof area. Even though you have an inclined roof, the wind load will be acting vertically downward, and because of which you are going to consider the plan area, this particular area that you are going to consider, and not the inclined area. So because of which the plan area of the truss, so in this particular slide you can see this is 6 meter and this is 12 meter. So you are going to consider the area, which is this particular area on which the live load is acting. We are not considering all the area because we are designing any one particular truss so that it will be replicated over the number of grid lines. So either you can design this, or you can design this, or you can design any of the truss, but we are not designing the end one because it will have a half of the loading, so that will be inappropriate and not conservative design, or not will not be suitable for the intermediate span. So we'll be using the intermediate trusses for the design. So the area will be 6 meter by 12 meter. Now considering this, you have the area, which is 12 meter by 6 meter, and the intensity of load that we have calculated is 0.58. So 0.58 multiplied by 12 multiplied by 6, it will be 41.76 kilonewton. So we can round it off to 42 kilonewton. So the live load acting on the truss will be 42 kilonewton on this particular structure. So this is the final live load that we have to consider for the design. So using this particular live load, we'll be applying this live load on the structure, and then we'll be combining this with the wind load and the dead load, and so that we can get the final maximum force in the members. So that we'll discuss in the subsequent lectures. In the next lecture, we'll be trying to deal with wind load calculation. So in the next lecture, be prepared for the wind load, and the suggestion for that is please get a copy of notebook, pen and a calculator, because the wind load part will be slightly tricky. It is easier to understand, but it is lengthy. So try to get the copies so that you will understand the parameters easily. And the most important part is get the IS 875 part 3. Thank you.